Yeah, actually this present movement is against an order which the UGC has passed on March 5th. Now the context is that the teaching faculty in the university, like in a college, say there are 150 posts, the rule was to implement a 200 point roster. So all the 150 teachers will be placed on the 200 point roster, and each category will get their required representation. That was the existing system. Now, in the last year, the Allahabad High Court had given a judgment against the BHU, Banaras Hindu University roster, saying that practice is bad and they should prepare department-wise or subject-wise roster. This was the order. Now, following that, the UGC and the MHRD on their own, although the Allahabad High Court judgment was actually not binding on all other universities, but the MHRD and UGC took this as a cue, and they have issued an order saying that henceforth all colleges and universities should change into the 13-point roster. Now what happens is that in the 13-point roster, since the point system, number of posts are less, for each category to get their representation, like I'll give an example, an ST post comes at the 14th point in that. Now if a department subject has like 6 teachers, if 6 teachers are appointed, obviously there will be no ST. In the next 6 teachers also there will be no ST. So ST will have to wait for 3 generations. Only on the 3rd generation of teachers come will an ST get a seat in that subject. Whereas if it is a 200 point roster, all the posts are clubbed, and maybe if not in one subject, at least in the other subject ST will get. But here ST will not get, and the same is true of OBC. OBC will not get that 27% unless they wait for 3 generations. So every category will have to wait for 3 or 4 generations to get their required percentage. And we are talking about more than 100 years here when you say 3 generations. Whereas the 200 point roster would ensure that everyone gets it in 2 or 3 rounds of. So this is the order we are fighting against. And this we feel is a backdoor move by the UGC to subvert reservation. The UGC is out to subvert reservation. Now they have also giving graded autonomy to colleges and universities. What this means is that they can start self-financed courses. The self-financed courses, there will be no reservation. Faculty recruitment also, there will be no reservation. So step by step, we are seeing that reservation is getting dismantled. Reservation is getting dismantled not after attaining the required reservation. That also we have to keep in mind. Even after 70 years of freedom, we have not got 15% of SC teachers in universities or colleges. We have not got 27% of OBC teachers. Actually, the representation is less than half in all. SCs may be around 10, OBCs again around 10, and STs around 2 or 3%. So in such a dismal are going to dismantle the whole thing. So whatever struggle which we are fighting for is taken away, and that is why we are on this. It is a nationwide strike. There are in many various universities the movement is going on, and the government is now forced to rethink, and we are sure we are going to win this thing.
बाबा साहब डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर करके रामा स्वामी पेरियार की स्टेचू तोड़ रहे हैं, इनको जो स्टेचू उन्होंने कभी घेरा है, तो आप जैसे पढ़े लिखे लोगों से कितनी बड़ी घेरा होगी?
See, what we find is a kind of, a concerted move to wipe out all symbols of uprising against the Brahminic hegemony. So wherever there has been rising against Brahmin supremacy is being all other cultures are being wiped out. So whether it be in your food culture, whether it be in respecting your leaders, so this is a very systematic conspiracy, I would say, which you see. And because how are these symbols important? These symbols are important because these remind us about our struggles. This inspire us for our struggles. So if Periyar has spoken against the domination of the Brahmins, against the domination of Sanskrit. He has spoken so much about Dravidian pride. So now that is the biggest threat, because the one particular ideology is about the Hindu Brahminical ideology, which pushes for certain culture, for the Hindi language and so on. And the others who are, do not belong it, who, if you are not Hindu, you do not belong here. If you don't speak Hindi, you are not there. If you don't, if you are not a Brahmin, then you are not there. So this is the move, as people rise against this, as the protest against this is rising, the counter move. So this is actually a counter move to wipe out all these kinds of cultures, and we have to educate ourselves and lead forward.
Thank you.